loves, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Eugene and beloved and free. I'm covering my chin a little bit and I have a little bit of hard time talking right now because I had a surgery on my left chin and my cheek side. I'm still a little bit numb right here. So my hair from here to bottom, I'm very uncomfortable talking right now because I had a fat grafting. I had asymmetric chin here. So I used to go to doctors and had fillers just to have a symmetric from here and here. So it was like way like smaller than here. So used to go to doctors twice a year and filled this side of my chin with filler. And eventually I got sick and tired of it because I hate needle. So I decided to go to a doctor who treated my acne, and I asked him if he could treat my asymmetric, my chin and cheek line. And he said it's possible, but I have to harvest my fat and I have to put fat here so I don't have to do filler anymore. So right now, you can see whole area right here just swollen. It's gonna take 3 to 6 months to completely decrease my swelling. So I'm only 1 month right now. So everything's just so uncomfortable right here. Even talking is just so uncomfortable. But I decided to do the YouTube because I can at least talk. It's better than before. So if you have like asymmetric problem on your face, then I think you should consider doing the fat grafting just to put a little bit more to the asymmetric area, so make asymmetric. So I had this huge handicap on my face, which nobody knew, because I always had a filler, so nobody knew that I had, you know, asymmetric shape here. But it's like right here and right here, like whole area is like so swollen. Even my lips and my like bottom cheek and everything is so swelling right now. So it's very hard for me to talk, but I'm gonna try to do review on some products today. So for the fat grafting, I've done 2 times so far, this one and when I had acne treatment after surgery. I had a little bit of fat grafting just to fill in the acne scar area, so it can look a little bit better and smoother, and I had good results from it. So I'm not really against fat grafting, long as you go to a good doctor. You have to find a good doctor, otherwise you're gonna mess up your face. I have seen so many cases that the woman went to the doctor for whatever reason, they wanted to do fat grafting. They ending up having big face or numbing on some areas and fat cheeks and asymmetric face shape. So even if you have to pay a little bit more, I recommend you to go to skillful and experienced doctor for fat grafting. So yes. Today, I'm gonna talk about retinol. Retinol cream is anti-aging cream. If you are 21 years and older, even though you may be young, I want you to start using anti-aging cream because even if you're 21, once you go over 21, between 21 to 25, your skin is gonna start losing collagen, and actually the aging process will start. So I want you to use anti-aging products, especially like retinol. Retinol is something that I really recommend you to use eventually every day. So the product I wanna talk about is from the brand name Skin Medica. Skin Medica is medical grade skincare products. I used to go to a lot of dermatologists and plastic surgeon doctors for my skin problem because I had a deep acne scar. So not plastic surgery, but for my skin surgery because I had a lot of scars and pimples before. But if, right now I have a pretty good skin right now. So whenever I go to doctor's office, most of time, like over 90% of the time, the doctors were carrying this Skin Medica product. So this is a retinol complex, 0.25. So there's a 0.25 is the lowest strength. So you can use from 0.25. After you get used to this, you can go up to 0.5 strength. After you get used to 0.5 strength, you can go up to 0.1 and over. So if you used to use retinol or any other vitamin A cream product and you have not used it for a long time, I want you to start lower strength and I want you to start slowly. Some woman wants to use it like every day. You haven't used it for a long time and suddenly you want to restart and you remember that it was good for you. So you're using every day. Then you're going to mess up your skin or you're going to like, your skin's gonna purge and you're gonna have a lot of pimple coming out. Otherwise, you're gonna suffer from like dryness. I mean, if you can endure that, yes, it's not like you can't, I'm not saying that you cannot do it, but it's gonna be painful. So what I do is start from the lower strength and once a week, 0.25 once a week. And if once a week is comfortable, after maybe a month or something, you can increase to twice a week. If twice a week is comfortable for your skin after a month or two, then you can increase to three times a week. If three times a week is okay for your skin and your skin is adjusting to it, then you can increase to like every other day. If every other day is okay after a few months, then increase to every day. So put this every night before you go to sleep. And I recommend you to put this in the end of your skincare steps. Some people use this as a first step, but if your skin get used to it, it's okay. But for myself or somebody who wants to try it and who haven't used it for a long time, I want you to start slowly and in the end of your skin step. So after your toner, serum, essence, lotion, night cream, and this one in the end, very end. So let me show you the consistency. It looks like a regular lotion. And another anti-aging product that I want to show you is this from Skin Medica, same brand, vitamin C. I can't see. Vitamin C plus E complex. So when vitamin C and E combines together, it's going to double the power. So you're going to benefit from vitamin C even more if vitamin C is combined with vitamin C. So I recommend you to use vitamin C product that's sealed like this. When you look at the container, the light cannot penetrate it into the product. So because vitamin C oxidizes when it sees the sunlight or when it's exposed to air, airtight container and the container that light cannot penetrate. Regular lotion. This one is for daytime. So you need a vitamin C on your skin during the daytime. So you need to put vitamin C before you go out. So there is the things that's gonna damage your skin outside, but vitamin C is going to protect your skin from those damaging agents. So I really recommend you to put vitamin C, anti-aging, retinol. I'm 44, but my skin is pretty good. It's because I always take care of my skin and I eat healthy, I exercise, and I don't do anything that harms my skin. once you damage your skin and once you get old, you can't really use product and make your skin younger again. It's just not possible with the products like this. So it's better to prevent and better to keep your skin youthful by using good product, eating healthy food, and living a healthy life and exercise. So you can prevent. And later on, if you have all these wrinkles and all these aging spots, then only thing you can do to fix it is go to doctor. And when you go to doctor, it's gonna be painful and you're gonna have to spend so much money. Why not using good product, just spend a little bit more money and prevent all that. And the another product that I wanna show you is tea tree oil. This is 100%. So you cannot put this whole face because this is 100% tea tree oil. I use this as a spot treatment because sometimes I have, like, you can see pimple right here and right here. So sometimes I have cystic acne or sometimes I have a small pimples coming out. Then I use this as a spot treatment. I've used other spot treatments before, but you know, those stuff doesn't really work. It works, but it takes like days or 1 week. But if you use just pure 100% tea tree oil as a spot treatment, this is gonna work better than any other spot treatment medication. So I recommend 100% tea tree oil for the spot treatment. Some people recommend retinol for people with a lot of acne, but I don't recommend any retinol. That's a whole another subject. So I can talk about that later. I don't recommend this retinol for people who want to clear their acne. There is a way to use it, but this is not the same kind of retinol or vitamin A cream. There's a different type of retinol, different types of vitamin A creams. So I'm gonna handle that subject later, and I'm gonna introduce you different types of retinoids. That's just for the acne skin or people who's suffering from acne. So stay tuned and please always check my YouTube, and I'm gonna bring more contents that's gonna benefit your skin. Anti-aging, anti-acne, anti-scar, even oily and even the dry skins. So I hope you enjoyed and I hope it was a beneficial for you. And if you liked it, please like my video. If you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe and please comment. And if you have a question, you can ask me any question and I'm gonna answer as much as I can. I hope you have wonderful and joyful weekends. And I'm going to see you next week. Thank you so much. And I'll see you next time.